Hey, what's going on, guys? It's Jason, your strength and confidence coach, and today I'm bringing you the first of the five essential habits for fat loss. And today we're going to be going over sleep. And now I know a lot of you may have been coming on here probably expecting some sort of fitness or nutrition tip. And while we are going to get to those things, I want to basically show you guys one of the most important habits that most people who are very successful in their fat loss journey are doing actively and paying attention to, and that's going to be how much sleep they get. So what we're going to be doing is going over exactly how much sleep that you're going to need for your fat loss journey, what are some of the negative consequences that sleep deprivation brings us, why is it important for us to be getting enough sleep, and what are some sleep aids in case you are struggling to get yourself that full restful night sleep. So let's just start off with how much. It's very simple, 7 to 9 hours, and I'm sure many of you have probably have heard that range before, and it continues to stay the same. Most Americans and most people in general, they tend to get less than 6 hours of sleep per night, and that is a very, very negative health consequence, or it can have a very negative health consequence if you are constantly getting less and less sleep each night. Like, for instance, fatigue is definitely going to wear in. You're going to feel a lot more tired throughout the day. You're going to have some experience with moodiness. You're not going to feel like your energetic, happy self because you're just so slumped and you can't wait to hit the hay again. You also have the fear of laziness, which happens when you are tired and you are fatigued. So making sure that you get enough sleep will help you have a productive day, along with actually sadness. And while a lot of people, especially nowadays, are struggling with having fulfilling lives and being happy, they actually are struggling a lot of their sadness with the fact that they're very malnourished, the fact that they don't get enough sleep. And if they were to just do some of those simple things, they would actually start to feel happier, more energetic, and more positive. So why is it that sleep is so crucial? Well, first off, it's going to help us burn more fat and help us build more muscle. During the time that you're sleeping is when your body is going to do all of the recovering that it needs to. So let's say you have an intense workout and you break down those muscles, and in order for them to come back bigger and stronger, you have to recover and have plenty of rest. So if you were only sleeping 6 hours versus 8 hours over 4 days period, you're actually getting almost an extra night's rest compared to what you were doing before. So that's going to carry over with how much growth you're going to see in your muscle, because there's going to be a lot better of a recovery process. Along with the burning of the fat, the longer that you're sleeping, the more time that your body has the chance to actually use its body fat as a source of energy for the next day, especially when you are following a calorie deficit protocol. So also too here, with, of course, our improved sleep, we're going to be increasing productivity, we're going to be improving our mood, we're going to have more energy, and we're going to feel more organized. So all of these aspects are so crucial in your weight loss journey. So many people just look at it as a diet or workout plan, but it actually is more so about the little things that you do on a daily basis that's going to bring you closer to those fat loss goals of yours. So I know that nowadays a lot of people have trouble with sleep, and insomnia is definitely on the high rise. So let's go over some quick little tips on how you can get yourself some more sleep. So regularity is one of the most important things. Having a regular sleep schedule, whatever time that you go to sleep should be regularly in that area every single night. Think about what time that you need to go to bed, or what time that you need to wake up rather in the morning, and then make sure that you're achieving that 7 to 9 hours by the time that you are going to bed. So let's say you need to wake up at 6 a.m., you make sure that you're in bed by 10 p.m., right? And you consistently show up and you consistently do that, so that way your body starts to just fall into a natural rhythm and routine. Along with that, you can also take some supplements in order to help you with sleep, like melatonin, which will help regulate your sleep cycle. And you can also take CBD oil in order to help reduce inflammation, reduce anxiety, reduce stress, and have you become a little bit more restful at night. Along with that, getting rid of the phone is probably going to be one of the biggest game changers out there. Most people are on their phone right before bed, and if you're on your phone before bed, the screen, the LED blue lights are going to be killing your natural melatonin production, making it a lot harder to fall asleep. Along with that, if you're checking your phone in the morning or you're checking it in the middle of the night, you're going to run into some major, major sleep problems. Also, if you want to have a little bit more of like a clearer state of mind, you can try out some meditation so that way your mind can just kind of shut off. You get a little bit more comfortable just laying there by yourself. And you can also fast or eat something depending on what kind of person you are. Some people prefer that they don't eat 2 hours before they go to bed, and on an emptier stomach, they feel really good that way. Some people like to eat right before bed because it helps them get to sleep. Depending on who you are, you could implement one of those strategies in order to help yourself get the best quality sleep. So that's essentially all we need to go over today. I'm gonna leave you guys with a little bit of a sleep assignment. In order for you to actually implement the thing that you learned today, you have to actually perform some sort of actionable step in order to create that habit. So my assessment to you, or my assignment to you rather, is going to be figuring out first for you, what time is it that you want to wake up on a regular basis? Do you want to wake up in the morning before work so that way you have time to go to the gym before your job? Do you want to wake up at a specific time so that way you can just get to work right away, or maybe you need to get the kids ready, or maybe you want to just get a nice, good, productive start off to your day? Know what time it is that you need to wake up on a regular basis. You can stem from it every once in a while, but that should be like your home base. For me, it's 6 a.m. 6 a.m. is my home base. It's not too early, it's not too late, and I feel very comfortable waking up at that time. So I always plan to go to bed at least 8 hours before that time, which will go into your second part, which is figuring out what time that you need to put yourself to bed. For me, 10 p.m. is my cutoff time. That's my bedtime, and I should stick with that rule as consistently as I possibly can. And now that you've developed a schedule and what time you want to wake up, what time you want to go to bed, now we're going to be doing our third assignment, which will probably be the hardest, which is to get rid of your phone 30 minutes before your bedtime. So for me, if I was to go to bed at 10 to wake up at 6, I would get rid of my phone, put it in another room at around 9:30, and then I would then begin the winding down process so that way I can get a good full night's rest. So anyway, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you guys found this to be helpful and that you can apply this to your lifestyle. All you want to do is just do those three things for now. Figure out what time you want to wake up, figure out what time you need to go to bed, and get rid of your phone before bed. Hit that up, and then you'll be able to get into the next essential habit, which will take you into the next training, and then you can start to apply that thing. So it's all about those small little baby steps. So try it out, guys. This is Jason, your strength and confidence coach, signing out.